Today we're going to talk about the promises of God and God's trustworthiness. Now, Ron, as I was reading my Bible the other day, I came across Titus chapter 1 and verse 2, where Paul makes a parenthetical statement there about God. He says, to God who cannot lie. And so if God can't lie, that means that I have to be able to trust what he says.
He is absolutely trustworthy, and that's a great passage to begin with, because Paul is introducing himself to Titus, and he talks about how he's living in hope of eternal life, and then he says, which God, who cannot lie, promised long ages ago. That eternal life is one of the promises that we can trust, and the reason is it's impossible for God to lie.
Right. Now, there are several other passages in the Bible that telling us that we can trust God in everything that he says. And you have some of those to talk about.
I do. You know, it's all been important for people to be able to depend on what God says. In Hebrews chapter 6 and verse 18, the writer is talking about the promises that God made to Abraham and how he confirmed those promises with an oath. And then it makes this great statement about the character of God in relation to that promise and that oath. It says that God cannot lie. He absolutely cannot lie. It is outside of his character to be able to lie. And there's another tremendous statement in the 21st chapter of the book of Joshua, where Joshua is going over everything that God has done for Israel. He talks about all those promises that he has made. And he says to Israel at the end of his life that every one of those promises has been kept. Not a single one of those promises failed. So again, we're told over and over again in the Bible that he is absolutely trustworthy.
Right. And I think it's really great to know that because God is so trustworthy, if he would have come to these people and told them the things to do, and they thought that he was lying, they probably wouldn't have done it. But so God's trustworthiness and our faith go together.
Exactly. In 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 13, he is talking about why in prison he's not discouraged or cast down. And he says, you know, if we are faithless, he remains faithful. And he cannot deceive himself.
Now, isn't it great to know that even when God may not be able to rely on us, we can always rely on God.
We can always trust God. And that means whatever promise we're talking about in the Word of God, we can count on God.